Hello, my name is Saravanan. I'm from FI Network. So I would like to share with some of the problems that I routinely encounter when working with the customer cases. So I often see a very miserious TLS handshake failure, and the log from Windows Server is not very useful. So after further investigation, I found that when after the client sent the client key exchange chain cipher spec and encrypted handshake message, it will typically expect a similar chain cipher spec and encrypted from the server, but instead I was directly getting a TCP reset. So upon further investigation, I noticed that it always happened only when I use the Diffie-Hellman ephemeral. It doesn't happen if I use EC-DHE, for example. So as you all know, the Diffie-Hellman typically have a common domain parameters. Then both the parties will exchange their public key and calculate the shared secret, and both the parties end up with the same shared secret. So in sometime what can happen is the resulting shared secret may contain a leading 00 byte. So in such cases, the TLS 1.2 RFC says you have to remove the leading 00 byte, and remaining byte you should use as a premaster secret. So what I found is Windows external TLS implementation is not RFC compliant. It is not stripping the leading 00 byte and directly taking the resulting thing as a premaster secret, and hence it ends up with a wrong master secret, and hence it's unable to decode the finish message from the other side. So when you will hit the bug is if one of your endpoint is a non-S-channel TLS implementation and the other endpoint is a Windows S-channel implementation, and if you are using DHE and if the shared secret end up with a leading 00 byte, then you will hit this particular bug. So when I tested, I found it is there in all the 2008, 2012, 2016, all versions contain the same bug. So what I did was, since I am not the guy who found this bug, it was there for a past couple of years. So I did a quick check on Google. On Google, some of the people have already reported this bug, but there is no public documentation on it. So in order to prove this bug, what I did was, I realized that on Windows, the Diffie-Hellman ephemeral is not 100% ephemeral. For up to 2 hours, it used the same parameters again and again. Where do I find this info? From one of the old paper called Imperfect Forward Secrecy, where it has mentioned Microsoft S-channel catches D^B for 2 hours. So I used it for my advantage, and what I did was I used the curl command line and connected to the server once with the DHE with the TLS 1.2, and I noted down the GP and the public key value. Then I wrote a small Python script. I created my own script and I tried what private key if I use, I will end up with a shared secret with a leading 00 byte. I noted down that private key and public key, and to inject that, I use an open source utility called TLS Attacker. I use this tool, I injected my own custom client key exchange with the calculated value, and straight away I can see the bug. So I tested with the, to my surprise, the bug is also there in some of the old Java version, and luckily all these bugs are fixed now, all are fixed. But for the Microsoft side, unfortunately, 1 second. From Microsoft side, I was checking with our developer whether have anybody contacted Microsoft on this. They told yes, they filed a bug ID, but Microsoft closed the ID, telling that Windows 7 is no longer supported, and they will consider in future version to fix this bug. But when I tested last year, I can still see from this. But later I contacted a Microsoft developer, Andre Popo. He mentioned that he did fix it in the upcoming Windows 2019. So when I tested with 2019, I found that it is indeed fixed, but it is not backported yet. That means you will still encounter this bug. So the reason for getting this bug ID is, in TLS 1.0, nothing has been mentioned whether to remove the leading 00 or not. Whereas in 1.1, they have clearly mentioned you have to remove the leading 00 byte. And in 1.2 also, they clearly mention you have to remove the leading 00 byte. So some implementation didn't strip the leading 00, and it become a interop issue with the non-compliance. So in summary, don't use DHE, switch to EC-DHE if you have not done it already. I appreciate if Microsoft come up with a public-facing documentation explaining this behavior and telling in which version they have fixed it. Otherwise, it's creating confusion to the customer. Customers start blaming the networking vendor, third party other vendors. Yeah, that's all. Thank you.